a couple seconds away from 901. We got Yo Gotti playing Five Star Chick. It's 901 right now. And so we have a special 901 edition right now. Joining us now is Holly Whitfield from I Love Memphis. And Holly, it's a special week because it's Downtown Dining Week, and we are going to have you kick things off to just to celebrate. What can we expect from this week?
This week is going to be awesome in Downtown Memphis. We have about 60 restaurants that are participating in Downtown Dining Week. So that can mean anything from they have special two-course meals, three-course meals, lunch specials. It could mean they're just doing something different with their menu. A couple of places that have been closed or mostly closed are now open. So all that's going on for lunch and dinner downtown. And then also this weekend, South Main started a new thing where they have bright Christmas lights or holiday lights, whatever you want to call them, up all over the fronts of the buildings downtown. So it's pretty picturesque to walk down South Main right now. So it's kind of got this celebratory air, which, let's be real, we all kind of need right now.
Definitely do. Absolutely. And as a downtowner and a diner, this is one of my favorite weeks of the year. I love food. I love living downtown Memphis. Put them together. Downtown Dining Week is great. This year feels extra important, though. I know this is their 12th year doing it, but considering everything that's gone on due to COVID-19 and how that's impacted so many restaurants' bottom lines, just how have you seen the expected impact of this week through the restaurant community?
So I think this week is probably crucial for a lot of people in restaurants, downtown. So we don't really have to get into a lot of detail about how difficult this year has been, but we do want to remind people that restaurants are struggling. It's not a normal year. And so it's really important that we support local this week. One thing I want to say, it's really important that we tip well, whether we're getting takeout or to-go or curbside or delivery, or we're eating on a patio. It's really important. And so I think both choosing to go downtown and participate in Downtown Dining Week is going to give the restaurants those dollars they need to stay open and maybe recover a little bit from this year. And then tipping is going to help all of our servers in Memphis make it. So this is just a crucial week for them. It's a non-traditional week. Normally every restaurant's kind of doing a similar special. This year they're getting a little more creative. So I really encourage people to participate for the reasons that you said, Jessica.
And for those who are trying to figure out how they can do this socially distance-wise, what are some of the protocols that some restaurants are doing? Can they do takeout, curbside, dine-in only?
So every restaurant is a little bit different. The vast majority of them, I would say, are offering a takeout option or takeout in some way. So if you want to do socially distance, you can definitely do that. I encourage you, I have a whole list of the restaurants participating on the blog, and Downtown Memphis also, of course, has their Downtown Dining Week guide. If there's somewhere that sounds good or that you want to give a try, just give them a call and see what they can set up for you in terms of curbside or takeout. A lot of places also have patios. So you have a lot of different options that you can do. If you do choose to dine in, excuse me, everybody's wearing a mask. And so that's just really important as well. So you do have options. If you're still not dining out or going out, you can still participate.
Absolutely. And you can find that full list at ilovememphisblog.com. Make sure you follow Holly at I Love Memphis on Twitter, on Instagram. Holly, you mentioned the patios. I saw you doing some crowdsourcing for patios with heaters, and this is something that is very important to me. What have you found for restaurants, especially here in downtown, maybe that have the heater situation as it is getting nice and chilly outside?
So I think that restaurants are still getting that set up, and we're still trying to kind of gather that list of who is going to have a heater. I'm going to say probably most of the places on Main Street and South Main are going to give you that heated dining experience. It's a little early to tell, which seems crazy because I know it was like freezing last night, but everything's happening all at once. So I'm hoping to put out a list of those heaters for you so you can stay cozy while you dine out. But I will say that probably most places are going to end up doing that.
Wow. And Hal, I know you said there's like over 60 restaurants. Have you mapped out your days and what places that you'll be, you know, going to yet?
So I have a few that I have my eye on for this year. Not to play favorites, but I did notice that 117 Prime, which is a really nice steakhouse, they're doing a $20.20 dinner special, a pork porterhouse. I don't really understand what that is, but I know they make great food. So that's exciting. Lunchbox Eats, which is kind of like an old school schoolhouse vibe. It's really neat if you haven't been there. They're open for lunch, but they've been closed for most of the pandemic, but they're opening for a $10.20 lunch special this week. So I've got to get over to Lunchbox Eats. It's right by the Forum. And then Felicia Suzanne's and Grecian Gourmet both have a ton of options if you want to do like takeout or family meal or something special. So I'm probably going to hit those up as well. And then I'm going to go into a food coma.
I was going to say, so are you going somewhere every day? It sounds like it.
We'll see.
That's what we try. Honestly, like we try to do that to support as many as possible, because especially in a year like this, when you mention over 60, you can't hit everyone or you will actually be in a food coma. But it's so hard to decide. Like, do we make a board and do like a little roulette board and just figure out where
to
land?
Of course, Jessica wants to do a board.
Of course I want to turn it into a game, because I can't make my mind up. I'm very indecisive, as we know on the show. Holly, for people who are looking on ways to get to all of these different restaurants, we saw this morning that you can actually rent bikes for free now through Saturday. How exactly does that work here downtown?
So Explore Bike Share, if you haven't done Explore Bike Share, it's awesome. They have stations all over the city, but certainly in high density downtown, you can go and you can rent a bike for an hour or two. And if you use the code, I believe it's DDW20, that will get you a free ride. So if you want to park your car somewhere, ride down Main Street, check out the lights, park your bike and enjoy a meal, you can get there at least for free.
And for those who are going, please post your pictures, Susan. Use the hashtag. I saw you use hashtag Downtown Dining Week. So that way everyone can see the food that you're eating on Twitter or Instagram as well.
Yes. And I know that Downtown Memphis is doing like a giveaway as well for people who post those photos. They're maybe doing a gift certificate. So check out Downtown Memphis on their social media and see how you can get in on some of that if you want to post your pictures. I know they're also using hashtag back downtown. So that's a fun one, too.
Oh, free food, free bike.
Are we still getting drinks to go? Is that still a thing? So we still get the Capri Sun pouches?
I don't know if they're still doing Capri Sun pouches. Holly, do you know?
I don't know if they're still doing Capri Sun pouches, but they are still doing drinks to go. That is a thing. And some places do have drink specials included in Downtown Dining Week, too. So, CJ, you'll be happy.
So you can do a little bit of everything. Holly, before we let you go, I wanted to ask you about your new video series. I saw it this weekend, the I Love Memphis Food, and you have local food experts giving insight into where they eat. Tell us a little bit about why you decided to do this and how it's been so far.
So this is a big part of our push for Rally for Restaurants. It all goes into the same thing as Downtown Dining Week, with we just want to remind people that your local restaurants depend on your business. So the thing that's so cool about I Love Memphis Food, the video series, we have 3 episodes out for now. We may do more in the future, but it's local chefs and foodies, people you probably have heard of or seen, and they're talking about their favorite places to eat. So it just ends up being this big love fest about Memphis food, and the videos will definitely make you hungry. People seem to love them. They're doing really well. And so they were so much fun to share with y'all. And again, they're going to make you hungry. So don't watch hungry.
I'm always hungry, so I don't know when I'll watch, but I'll just watch and be hungry. That's totally fine. Holly, thank you so much for celebrating and getting us all the information about Downtown Dining Week. Like Jessica said, if you want to hear more from Holly Whitfield, make sure you follow I Love Memphis on Twitter and Instagram. And please check out her blog about Downtown Dining Week. It has all the restaurants. I just controlled F curbside takeout for those who, if you have different options for you. I'm super excited about it. Holly, I hope you don't get in a food coma, because we got to have you back on the show.
I would love to. Thanks, guys, for having me.
Have a good one, Holly.
All right, when we come back, we'll get to some pop of the morning. We'll break down what's going on with Kim Kardashian and everything else.
We're so excited to get into it. We're going to get into it right now.
Okay, let's go.